So now we move on to the 12th award, the Sports Story of the Year. And to present this award, it gives me great pleasure to invite Peter Kellner, chairman of YouGov, to the stage. I think it's probably my London upbringing, but whenever I hear YouGov, in my head, I automatically go, yes, squire. in this category, the first nominee is Ed Caesar, writing in the New York Times Magazine with, "It's more like a suicide than a sport." Ed Caesar writes about base jumping, a profoundly dangerous sport in which people jump from fixed objects like cliffs, bridges, and buildings with only a tiny parachute to break their fall. He tells a story of the death of one of the bravest base jumpers who died in a wingsuit flying accident last year. The second nomination for Sports Story of the Year is Catherine Mayer, Times Editor-at-Large, together with Stephen Farris for The Meaning of Mario. This piece is a profile of Mario Balotelli, the Manchester City and Italian football star, his mercurial brilliance and his turbulent relationship with his manager. And the final nomination is from CNN. It's Don Riddell, Samantha Bresnahan, Sheri England, Kathy Kudravi, and Bill Galvin for World Sports Presents Branded a Rebel. This is a documentary about the controversial 1983 West Indian cricket tour to South Africa at the height of the apartheid era. Lured by huge financial offers, a group of West Indian cricketers had agreed to take part in the rebel tours, and the repercussions of which still resonate because of the downward spiral that their lives took afterwards. The jury thought the winner was a fascinating and well-told story that reminded us how much things have changed in the past 30 years. The winners of Sports Story of the Year are Don Riddell, Samantha Bresnahan, Sheri England, Kathy Kudravi, and Bill Galvin for World Sport Presents Branded a Rebel for CNN. Oh, I beg your pardon, I've misread. I've made a classic error. Don Riddell and his team can't be here tonight, so his award will be collected by Deborah Rayner, who I don't think that is, Managing Director EMEA for CNN, who's changed sex. Interesting. I don't know quite how that's worked. Anyway.
Introduction. Firstly, I think just as a sports journalist, I should say that unfortunately England were defeated tonight 1-0 for anyone who doesn't have reception down here. So there's my duty required. Look, thanks on behalf of my colleagues over in Atlanta for this. 30 years on, we felt that mercenaries or missionaries, I think we're all very aware of apartheid in the story. We just felt that 30 years on that these West Indian rebels and that story hadn't been told. So just like to thank the three contributors towards that, Franklin Stevenson, who you saw in that clip especially, and also our team, Don, Sheri, Bill, Kathy and Samantha, who produced it. And thanks to CNN for the resource and, backing for it. So thank you.